With another month of Terran development behind us, let's take a look at what's new across design, build, test, and launch. In October, the team completed 11 component-level critical design reviews. There was also a concerted effort on second-stage fluids components, and the team rallied to release all machine parts ahead of manufacturing need dates. In avionics, flight designs for the high-voltage power distribution box, stage controller, and actuator controller printed circuit board assemblies were released. Flight builds continue across all aspects of Terran R. The team installed the downcomer and forward test adapter on the Stage 2 tank in preparation for acceptance testing. On the first stage, tank welding continues, with fuel tank friction stir welding complete alongside painting barrel sections, completing dome and barrel mechanical assembly, and installing composite overwrapped pressure vessels. Thrust structure integration continues, with avionics trays and secondary structures bracketry installed. Fabrication of the interstage has begun, with panel production and barrel weldment in progress. The team completed a weld development campaign on the newly activated horizontal friction stir welder. Instead of welding stringers on the vertical friction stir welder, which also joins panel sections, this dedicated resource will increase weld capacity and improve flow time for future flight manufacturing. This month, the team completed thrust structure hardware-in-the-loop hardware integration, providing a testbed for vehicle software, avionics, and partner teams to validate designs, automation, and configuration prior to use on the vehicle thrust structure. The milestone brought together a flight-like table build with all thrust structure avionics box designs and quantities, equivalent ground infrastructure, capable test infrastructure that simulates avionics endpoint devices, and table functionality to execute flight-like concepts of operations. In propulsion, the team completed manufacturing and assembly of two additional engines, which were shipped to NASA Stennis for testing. In Long Beach, we continue to expand our production capacity, with dozens of new powder bed fusion printers and CNC machines ordered and installations beginning. These machines will increase engine manufacturing throughput and support future flight scaling. Propulsion hardware for Terran R's third flight is already being manufactured, with gimbal sockets, gas generator injectors, and turbopump impellers being actively printed. Propulsion testing continues to ramp up across our test stands at NASA Stennis. On the R stand, we completed the first round of Stage 1 flight engine acceptance testing and continue to test the second stage vacuum engine development article. At E2, the team executed high-flow thermal shock testing of our stage press valve, simulating the harsh thermal conditions the valve will experience during Stage 1 relight. On the A2 stand, renovations continue in preparation for Terran R stage testing. Wide flange steel support beams have been installed for structural reinforcement, and welding on the live ring, the structure that holds the stage in place during testing and absorbs thrust and vibration, is underway. In parallel, the environmental control system vaporizer, which converts cryogenic liquids into controlled gas flow, has been lifted into place. The team at Cape Canaveral continues to make progress at LC-16. Work on the horizontal integration facility continues, with siding panels and roofing being installed. The water tower is now being erected, currently standing 60 feet tall and climbing. Piles for the lightning protection system have been installed, and construction is kicked off on a flare stack for the liquid natural gas system. Fabrication of the pad support facility has begun, with foundations being poured. And the launch mount rebar is in full swing, with rebar and formwork ongoing throughout the month. With key progress across primary structures, manufacturing, acceptance testing, and infrastructure build-out, October was another busy month for the Terran R program. Every milestone brings us one step closer to first launch and beyond.